Happy Easter, everybody. Thanks for joining us at our squash court, and hopefully you'll be joining us next Saturday, April 18th at noon, for Super Squash Saturdays. Now, we're going to be playing this challenge match that we've made up, Diego and I, over the past few weeks, throughout the entire COVID-19 process, where we're going to be playing a match every week at noon, and we've been sort of going back and forth with each other nonstop about who's going to win this match. I've got a lot of messages from a lot of people saying, how is this going to be competitive? How are you going to play with Diego? You're 46, he's 23, he's top, one of the top players in the world, you're an old fat guy. So, like, you're all right. It's not going to be competitive if we played straight up, but I thought I could use this opportunity to educate people a little bit about the history of squash in the Americas. So, both of us, Diego and I, have probably been the most successful squash players in the Americas over the last 140 years since squash has been invented in, or not invented, but played in America, from Canada all the way down to Argentina. And because of the weather here in Canada, when squash was brought over from England in the 1880s, I would say, around, the ball didn't bounce very much. It was freezing in winter here. Everybody knows about the Canada cold. So we came up with a hard ball in order to have the ball bounce a little bit more and have the rallies a little more competitive, and the ball moves a hell of a lot faster. So the origin of squash in the Americas started with this hard ball. And because Diego and I have been the most successful squash players from the Americas, we wanted to lay down a hardball squash challenge. So we're going to be playing a match every week, Saturday at noon, best 3 out of 5, to 11 points, win by 2, everything the same, rules of squash. The only difference is we're going to reintroduce the 2-serve rule, because then we can be a little bit more aggressive with the hardball serve. But other than that, it's going to be the squash that you know. It's very quick, very fast, very exciting. All decisions will be decided that are disputed between the two of us are going to be decided by a spin of the racket, and there'll be no more arguing from there. Maybe a few eye rolls, maybe a few fingers when the guy's not looking, but we can edit that out. but anyway, we're gonna have a real squash challenge over the next time where we're quarantined together. So hopefully you can join us, and where the real pride comes in and where the real, I guess, competition comes in is that the winner of this match that we're playing every Saturday is going to be crowned champion and king by the other guy. So I want to introduce you to the crown that we'll be playing for, and one of us, the loser, will have to place this lovely crown on the other guy's head. So that's going to be awfully painful, but it doesn't stop there. Not only do we have to place it on the guy's head after we lose, we have to let him ride around on our backs while we're on all fours around the court in its entirety, while the other guy screams, "You are the champion, you are the champion, you are the king." So it's going to be awfully embarrassing, awfully painful. I think it's worse than playing for top prize money on the World Squash Tour. I think this is probably going to be more competitive, more ugly, more desperate than you've ever seen before. So I can't wait for you guys to come out and join us next week. It starts, but it's going to be every Saturday at noon, April 18th. Be there. Hopefully, see you then.